So you said they're out. So they're out of Illinois. So where are they located physically?
In Summit, in Chicago.
You don't have a physical address for them?
I do, but I cannot give you that until we check your record.
Why you can't give me the address?
I don't know. That's the policy they require me to follow. Until we check your record, I cannot give you any personal information about the company.
Okay, so is this the person I'm talking to in the chat?
Yes, this is Ivy.
Okay, so Ivy, help me understand something. The companies that you guys are recruiting for, you have a company called NIS Express, IVS CIF. And
logical lines.
Oh, okay. Or logical lines. Yes. I'm sorry. So help me understand something. These companies with the three letters, they abbreviated. Where are they located at? Because I haven't heard of none of those companies.
So CFI is located in Missouri. IVS and NIS are located in Chicago, Illinois. And the last one, Logical Lines, is located in New Jersey.
Okay, so we got a Missouri company, CF.
New Jersey company.
So wait. So it's CIF, not CFI. Let me make sure I get the
right. CFI.
Oh, CFI. So it is CFI, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, so CFI out of Missouri, I am familiar with. You got two companies out of Illinois, which I'm assuming are 1099 companies, and then you got one up in New
That's
Jersey.
That's true. Yes.
Okay.
You got it all right.
So you're recruiting, or you're looking for drivers for those.
Yes, I'm looking. Drivers for those companies. I'm a recruiter.
Okay. So for the companies out of Illinois, where are they based out of? And what I mean by that,
Summit, Chicago.
No. What I mean by that, are they a foreign company? Are they Russians, Europeans?
No. They're all American.
The two companies out of Illinois.
Yes, they're American.
They're American. How long they been in existence?
Over 10 years.
The two companies in Illinois been in existence over 10 years. Do they have anything to do with one another, or are they two separate entities?
Two separate companies.
Okay, so let's start with the NIS. What are they offering?
So NIS is offering a position for a drive and truck driver. They offer 70 cents per mile and a minimum of 3,000 miles per week. They require a minimum of 3 weeks on the road, and you get 3 to 5 days off. We run all 48 states, as I've said earlier, except Northwest and New York City. What else? Fully equipped.
So this
with refrigerator, microwave, inverter.
Okay, so this is company NIS Express, right? You giving me the information for them, right? Okay, so you said they're out. So they're out of Illinois. So where are they located physically?
In Summit, in Chicago.
You don't have a physical address for them?
I do, but I cannot give you that until we check your record.
Why you can't give me the address?
I don't know. That's the policy they require me to follow. Until we check your record, I cannot give you any personal information about the company.
Personal information? Is that coming? Yeah. Is that coming from them? How is a business personal?
Don't ask me, sir. I'm just following the requirements.
Okay. Well, so this is in.
They always say just check the record and then you can give the address.
Interesting. Okay. So this is NIS Express out of Illinois. Okay.
Chicago, Illinois.
Okay. So the other company, IVS out of Illinois, what they got to offer?
They have the same thing, 70 cents per mile and 3,000 miles per week, but they do only reefers.
Okay. Now, what's their physical?
What do you drive?
What's their physical address?
They're in Chicago as well.
Okay, but what's the address? Because you know, Chicagoland is vast.
I cannot give any addresses in.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
Okay. Now CFI is out of Missouri, so I'm familiar with them. That's a mega carrier, right? What information can you give me? You can give me their physical address, right?
I'm not allowed to give anybody's physical address. They just want me to tell you they're from Joplin, Missouri, and that's it.
Well, I'm familiar with CFI, and I actually do know where they're located at physically.
There you go. You might know more than I do.
What did they tell you that they have to offer?
They're offering 60 cents per mile and a minimum of 2,700 miles a week. And they do 1099 and W-2 at the moment.
Okay. And the last company, Logistical Lines, and you said they're located out of New Jersey. What do they have to offer?
New Jersey, yes, that's correct. And they offer 65 cents per mile and a 3,000 miles per week.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you. I do appreciate the time. We'll go from there. But thank you, though.
Of course.
All right.
If you need any other information, let me know. I can maybe find out something for you.
Not a problem. Thank you very much, ma'am. Okay, so in summary, I get this Facebook message from a recruiter. Her name is Ivanka, or Ivana. If I'm pronouncing the name wrong, I'm sorry. I beat people's names up all the time. But she reached out to me in the Facebook and asked me if I was looking for a truck driving job. I go, what do you have to offer? She comes back and says they got an offer starts at 60 cents per mile with 2,700 miles per week. It goes up, depends on experience. They run all 48 states except for Northwest and New York, I believe. She said the trucks are just a few years old, fully equipped and regularly maintained. So I go, say, what's the name of the company and where are you out of? Now, the company is a recruiting company. The company is a recruiting company, and the recruiting company is WBN Logistics. They recruit for a couple of companies, NIS, that's Nancy It Sam Express, IVS, that's Italy Victor Sam, she got CIF, but it's actually CFI. You guys are familiar with that. And Logistical Lanes. So, of course, you guys heard what she got to offer. I personally, if you can't give me a physical location of where these companies are at so I can actually go and look them up and see, you know, what type, you know, what type of company it is, I'm not interested. I'm sorry. I'm just not interested, and I'll tell you why. Because if these companies could be fly-by-night companies, these companies, if you can't get the information, if they can't tell you where the company is located at physically, then these are not the companies you need to drive for. These are probably companies for drivers that needs a second chance. I'll give you that. If you need a second chance, if you can't get it, if nowhere is offering anything, then this might be the company to go with that might help you out so you can at least put some money in your pocket. But if you're a driver like me that don't have no issues or anything like that, then these companies right here are red flags to me. That's just me. I don't want to work for a red flag company. I want to make sure that when I deliver the load or pick up the load, deliver the load, I want to make sure I get paid. I don't want no issues with my money. And a lot of these companies like this, people seem to have issues with their money. Whether you decide to leave and they hold your check, or something happened with the shipper and receiver and you drop it off and you haven't gotten paid, we're not trying to go there. And I just feel that these type of companies just want to, you know, they hold so much information back from you so you won't be able to find out critical parts of these companies. These companies, with the exception of CFI, I haven't heard of, period. Like, period. I haven't heard nobody talk about it in the Facebook groups. I don't see no advertisements, nothing. I went to look up one of the companies and they don't even have a website. Well, they got it show up on the Google search, but then when I click on it, they don't have a website. So that's a red flag to me. And it should be a red flag to you, unless you're the type of driver that has some issues and you need to get with a company to help resolve them. Other than that, these companies right here is apply at your own risk companies, with the exception of CFI, because I'm familiar with CFI. But if a recruiter gets a hold of you and try to recruit you for any kind of companies and they can't give you a physical address, and then they tell you, well, until you put your information in, and then we'll give you our information. It don't work like that. I'm not going to give you no critical information if I don't know where you're located at. And what I mean by critical information, your driver's license number, your social security number, your address or whatever. If you can't get no critical information about where they located at and any information that you can look up and see if there's any resources, I'll just say this much. Apply at your own risk. Who's next?